Good morning to all present here. In today's topic, we are going to see the main important topic in computer networks, that is ISO OSI reference model. ISO is a multinational body, so it is nothing but it is International Organization for Standardization. It was developed in the year 1947, so it is a multinational body on international standards. Okay, and OSI is a model. It is nothing but open system interconnection. This was developed in 1970. This OSI model will cover all the aspects of network communication. So ISO is an organization and OSI is a model which covers that all the network communication. Suppose when any two open systems wants to communicate, they have to follow the OSI model. So this OSI model, purpose of this OSI model is to facilitate communication between any two open system without requiring any changes in the hardware and software. Okay, so this ISO is an organization and OSI is a model. Okay, so in this ISO OSI model, it is called as ISO OSI model. In short, we can call it as OSI model. So in OSI model, it has 7 layers: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. So in the last lecture, we have seen about protocol layering. So when any larger problem, it can be decomposed into smaller ones and it can be sent to the layers. So that is why in this OSI model, it has 7 layers. So a message will be sent to in all the 7 layers and it will be sent to the other side. So these are the 7 layers of OSI model. So in this slide, in this diagram, you can see that a device A wants to communicate with device B. So in between, it has 2 intermediate nodes. So when a device A wants to send a message to device B, it will prepare a message, it will send it to an application layer, which in turn send to presentation, session, transport, network, data link, physical, and through physical, from the physical layer, it will be sent through any transmission medium. It will reaches an intermediate node. In the intermediate node, the message will be passed to physical, data link, and network. Why it is sending to network layer is, in network layer only all the routing information will be, it will do all the routing process. That is why it will be sent up to network layer of intermediate node, and again it will send to the other intermediate node, and again from there it will be sent to the destination node. So in the destination node, the message will reach physical, data link, and in turn it reaches the application layer of your the device B. So this is how the data will be sent from the device A to device B. So here, when the data is in the physical layer, it is called as a bit. So when it is in data link layer, it is called as frame, and when it is network layer, it is packet. And in transport, it is transport packet data unit, and in session, it is called as session packet data unit. In presentation, it is called as presentation packet data unit, and in application, it is called as application packet data unit. So in this diagram, we have seen how the message is being transmitted from one device to another device. So in this diagram, we can see that how the message is sent. Suppose Annie wants to communicate with Maria. So Annie will prepare a data and it will send the data to application layer. Application layer will add its own header information. Header information will contain some address information, or whatever the data that application layer wants to do, all those things will be there in header. Those header will be added to your data and it will be sent to presentation layer. Presentation layer, it will consider it as a data and it will add its own header, it will send to session. Likewise, it goes on. When it reaches data link layer will add its own header and trailer. So why the trailer is added to the data is, this will show the end of the data. Now the data will be converted into bits. All the header, everything will be converted into bits, and these bits are transmitted through transmission medium or any cable, coaxial cable, optical fiber, any cable, through any cable the bits will be transmitted, and from there it reaches a destination node. In between, if it is having any interminable nodes, it will go to network layer, and again from there it reaches your destination node. From the destination node, the bits will be sent to the next layer. Likewise, it goes on, it reaches the destination Maria. So now the message will be, again it will be, this data link layer will remove the header, it will get the data. Likewise, it will remove all the headers. Likewise, it goes on, the message at last it reaches the Maria. So this is how the information will be sent in between the layers. So now we will see the description of each layers. First, coming to the physical layer. Physical layer, mainly this is the lowest layer in ISO/OSI model, and this layer is responsible for transmitting the raw bits over the physical medium. So from the data link layer, it is getting the data, it is converting into bits, and the bits will be transmitted to the transmission media. It will be sent to the destination side, and from there the bits will be received, and it will be the bits will be again it will be sent to data link layer. So this physical layer main function is that when it is sending one, it has to make sure that one has been sent to destination, not zero. So this is a main function of physical layer. So it has to ensure the same bits has been transmitted to the other end without any correction. Okay, this is what this physical layer will do. Next, coming to data link layer. So data link layer, so here the data is called as frame. It will convert the data it is getting from network, it will convert into a frame, it will add a header and trailer into it, and now it will be sent to the physical layer. So this physical layer is also provide hop to hop delivery, and in other side the same reverse process takes place. So this has to confirm that, like, when the data has been sent, so an acknowledgement can be sent from the destination side. So that acknowledgement also will be taken care by the data link layer. Next is network layer. So coming to the network layer, so here it is called as a packet over here. So the data from the transport layer, it will be converted into packet, and it is added with header, it will be sent to data next lowest layer. So here the packets, this layer will provide internetworking. In other side, the same reverse process takes place. So network layer will ensure that all the routing information will be present in this. So whenever a data wants to be sent from one end to the other end, it has to follow some route. So those routing information will be available in this network layer. So this will take care of all the packets for routing. Next is transport layer. So transport layer, it will divide. So we usually know that it's a modular design where the larger problem is divided into smaller sub segments. So here the data will be the bigger one, it will be divided into smaller sub segments, and it will be sent to network layer over here. So this will see to that all the smaller units will be combined, and it should make sure that all the segments should arrive the other end properly. This is the main functionality of this transport layer. So it will divide it into smaller segments, all the data will be divided to smaller segments, and these segments will be sent to network layer. And network layer this transport layer has to make sure that all the segments will be combined properly in network layer, and it will be sent. Next is session layer. So coming to the session layer, what it does is, session layer is responsible for establishing the session between two different networks. So this will also make sure that the synchronization, so whenever any two sessions have opened, so it has to make sure for synchronization between the two sessions and dialogue control. All these functions are done by this session layer. So whenever a data is received, it will add the synchronization bit to provide synchronization. It will send the data to transport layer. In other say, the same process taken place. So the next is presentation layer. So the presentation layer, this layer will make sure for syntax and semantics of the information. So whenever a data has been sent, the same format should be it should be known by both the sender and receiver. If the sender is sending in one format, and if the receiver cannot understand the particular format, then the message will not be heard by the this destination end. So what happens is that this will look into all the syntax and semantics of the information. So now it will add the header, it will send this, and it is also responsible for compression, encryption and translation. So last is application layer. Coming to the application layer, it provides all the services to the users. So whenever this application layer will provide all the services. So what happens is that when the main protocol this supports application layer is HTTP protocol. So whenever you browse it in your browser, so you request for some page, and the server, what it does is it will go and search for that particular page. It will give you back that particular page. So that is done with the help of a protocol called HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So this is one of the protocol that service it is done by this application layer. Now other protocols, which is other services done by this application layer, or Telnet. Telnet is used to, suppose whenever a user wants to log in into a distant machine, he can use Telnet and he can work in that distant machine from remote place. That service is done by Telnet. And FTP is file transfer protocol. It is used for transferring the files between two different systems. And SMTP is simple mail transfer protocol, and this is used for making the electronic mail. So all these services are done by this application layer. So in this ISO OSI model, we have learned about the seven layers and the functionality of all the seven layers, and we have seen how the message has been transmitted from one end to other end. Okay, thank you.